I'm going to show you four fantastic ways to save video with PowerDirector. ¿Qué pasa, mi PowerDirector gente? Thanks for choosing this tutorial to learn how to be Captain Save a Video with PowerDirector. If you use PowerDirector and you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider clicking the subscribe button and clicking the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. Using PowerDirector, you can save a project so you can come back to it later and make additional edits, or you can produce a video to share it with others via a file, a DVD, or on social media. We'll start off learning how to save videos. Saving creates a .pds file of the project that can only be opened using PowerDirector. You can't use these files to watch or share the video outside of PowerDirector. The first thing I recommend doing is setting up your autosave under Preferences. This automatically saves your project at the intervals that you want. You want to go up here to Preferences, and then you want to select Project. And then under Autosave, you want to make sure that that's enabled. And you can change this anywhere from 2 minutes to 120 minutes. If you end up in a pickle one time and you need to find out where are those autosave files, well, you can just go ahead and click on Browse. And it'll show you the path that you choose to get to those autosave files. So here it's on local drive C, then it goes to users and yada, 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 all the way down. You get the picture. Also, if you want to go ahead and select a different location to save the files, this is where you go ahead and choose that location. The next way to save a video is by using the Save Project option. So to do that, you can go right up here to this little disk and you can go ahead and click on this Save Project icon. Then you can name your file, whatever you want to name it. And you can go here and select a location where you want to go ahead and save the file. I'm going to leave it at the current location. And when you're done, you go ahead and click on Save. You can also access this option using the file menu. So through the file menu, you go to File, and then you click on Save Project. And if you select the Save Project option after you've already saved the project before, it overwrites the last saved version of the project. So it's not going to ask you to name it. It's not going to ask you to pick a location. It's just going to overwrite it wherever you created the last one. Now, I try to stay away from this option because I want multiple versions of my project in case one version becomes corrupted, then I don't only have one version of the project to depend on if something goes wrong. So in order to save multiple versions of your project, you would use the third option, and that's Save Project As. So to do that, you go to File, and then you go to Save Project As. This option will always ask you to name it. And so right now you can see that it notices that there's already a saved project, which is a .pds file here in this location. So what I would do is I would change the name to maybe Test 2, so that I know it's the same project, but it's the second version of that project. Then if I wanted to save it in a different location, I could. And then when you're done, you go ahead and click on Save. Now, let's say I wanted to open up a project. I can just go ahead and I'm just going to click on New Project to get rid of this one. If I wanted to open up one of those projects that I was using before, then all you have to do is go to File and Open Project. You can select the project that you want to open and click on Open. It'll go ahead and ask you if you want to go ahead and merge the files with the current files. I usually select no on this, and then it goes ahead and brings the project back into PowerDirector and adds it back to your timeline. Now we're going to talk about producing a video. Producing a video creates a video file that can be viewed outside of PowerDirector. So if you want to view it on a TV, you want to share it to a social media site, any of that stuff, this is how you get that done. There are two ways to produce a video. The first way is you can go to File and then go to Produce File, or you can just click on the Produce button right here on the interface. The next thing that you want to do is select your file format. Then you want to select your file extension. After that, you should pick your profile name. And when you're done, you can select any other additional settings that you want to use. Once you pick all of these options, you want to go down here to these three dots. This is the export folder. When you click on that, you pick the location on your computer where you want to save the produced video file. And once you have your location picked, you go ahead and click on save. And then once you're done, you go ahead and click on start. Now, if you want to see my full tutorial on how to produce a video, the link will be in the video description. And once this is all done, you're ready to save, share, and watch some videos. If you like what you see, I'll leave links to try Power Director for free and buy Power Director in the video description. Using those links helps to support the channel so I can make more content for you. I know you want more Power Director love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.